Tonight on NewsWatch, deadly day in Ukraine. How fighting is intensifying ahead of an important election this weekend.
Plus, terror attack in China. More on the radical Islamic group being blamed for the deadly explosion.
And CBN News hears from both sides of the so-called Cold War. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. Good evening. I'm Mark Martin.
And I'm Lori Johnson. The legitimacy of a presidential vote in Ukraine is in question just 3 days before the election.
That comes as safety concerns are on the rise across Ukraine. Pro-Russia insurgents attacked a military checkpoint, killing 13 troops. Heather Sells has more in tonight's top story.
Pro-Russian fighters ambushed Ukrainian soldiers overnight in the deadliest attack in weeks. The insurgents made off with the weapons, leaving behind more than a dozen bodies and the charred remains of their vehicles. Today, there's more violence across eastern Ukraine as the Ukrainian army tries to flush out the separatists. Ordinary citizens are caught in the middle. The fighting destroyed this woman's cafe. How can we live like this? She asks. Ukraine's leaders wonder how they can hold fair and safe elections on Sunday. In some eastern areas, election officials and voters have already faced intimidation and even death threats from the rebels. International election observers are calling for peace.
We ask for the cessation of all violence.
Russian President Vladimir Putin has ordered his troops to pull back from the border, and some have begun. But NATO says it's too early to assess how many are pulling out, and the Ukrainian government says Putin is merely bluffing. The expected winner in Sunday's election, chocolate manufacturer and billionaire Petro Poroshenko. His rival, Yulia Tymoshenko, is the former prime minister. Poroshenko is known as a dealmaker and a cool-headed politician, which could be a winning combination for Ukraine right now. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Chinese authorities believe radical Muslims are behind a deadly terror attack in the northwest province of Xinjiang. At least 31 people were reportedly killed, more than 90 wounded. Attackers drove off-road vehicles through a busy open-air street market in a busy city, throwing explosives into the crowds before crashing head-on. The attack is the region's latest one in a series of violent acts. Officials suspect a Muslim separatist group is behind those attacks.
Our senior international correspondent George Thomas has been reporting on the Uyghurs for years and has been to Western China, and he joins us now with more. Welcome, George. Thanks. Now, who are the Uyghurs exactly?
There are about 10 million of them, Mark. They predominantly reside in the western part of China. I've been to Xinjiang province, and it's majority Muslim. They're majority Muslim. They have an affinity to the Turks, and there are about 6 to 7 million Uyghurs that live today in Turkey. But in essence, they're of the poorer class. They're less educated than the Han Chinese, which is the dominant ethnic group in China. And they have, in essence, been fighting for an autonomous region, as Lori pointed out, and that's the friction.
Why are they against the Chinese government specifically?
And to that point, I mean, it's about you know, creating a self-autonomous region that is separate from the control of Beijing. They look at their culture as distinctive Islamic. They would like to have their women wear the hijab, their men to grow their long beards. What has happened in the last 5 to 10 years, the Chinese, the Han Chinese, the main ethnic group, they have been flooding into Xinjiang province and changing the topography, the landscape and the cultural the demographic of the country. And so the Uyghurs feel extremely vulnerable that the Han Chinese are, in essence, taking over their religion, taking over their culture, as well as their language.
So is this a serious Islamic threat?
Look, it is to an extent. I mean, since January, there have been about 10 attacks. What I am concerned about is that all these previous attacks have gone after police installations. What you have seen today in the last 24 hours even in March and earlier in the year, they've been going after softer targets, more bolder, and that is of serious concern.
Well, how is China responding to the threat, George?
I mean, look, in these cases, China has a heavy hand. They've sent in their military. They have, in essence, cracked down on the access to the internet, to YouTube, to Twitter feeds in Xinjiang province. They are, I mean, clearly they want to have a firm grip. But also economically, their idea is let's flood the Xinjiang province with economic opportunities. Let's give the people of the community an access to money, access to business, so that in that way, it will take their mind off of this idea. Let's create an autonomous region. Let's not be separate from Beijing. So there's a two-prong approach. Firm hand, but also economic response, economic resources.
Okay. Our senior correspondent, George Thomas, thanks as always.
You're welcome.
Lori.
Thailand's military is suspending the country's constitution. The move comes hours after Thailand's military chief announced a government takeover, saying they're working to prevent violence and restore stability to the nation. The military is establishing a national curfew and ordering 18 government officials, including the ousted prime minister, to report immediately to the country's new governing military commission. Although the bloodless coup has dissolved the government and the constitution, the Senate remains in place.
The United States is stepping up efforts to help find the more than 200 Nigerian girls kidnapped by Boko Haram. 80 U.S. military personnel and an unarmed Predator aircraft have arrived in neighboring Chad to help. In a recent Capitol Hill hearing, House Foreign Affairs Committee Chairman Ed Royce said Boko Haram is waging a brutal war on schoolgirls, saying the U.S. must take action against the terror group.
We care about a girl's right to an education. We care about human rights and religious liberty and the future of Africa's largest country.
In a letter to U.S. lawmakers, President Obama said the U.S. will remain on the ground until its support is no longer needed to bring the girls home. A senior defense official says the mission is not to get Boko Haram, but to get the girls.
The House is taking a step to curb the NSA's collection of every American's phone records. Today, it passed the USA Freedom Act. It reorganizes the most controversial program exposed by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden. The bill would stop the NSA from collecting the phone records of Americans, but it would still order the phone companies to keep that information for 18 months so the NSA can search it for terrorist threats. President Obama supports the measure, but opponents say the bill doesn't actually end the bulk collection of Americans' private information.
Two Christian colleges have won a temporary victory in their fight against the birth control mandate in the president's health care plan. A federal judge ruled Dort College in Iowa and Cornerstone University in Michigan don't have to comply with the mandate for now. The mandate requires employers to provide birth control coverage to employees, even coverage for abortion-related drugs. The schools argue the mandate violates their religious freedoms.
Violent weather sweeping across much of the country this week. Major storms are headed toward the East Coast tonight. And while the Midwest is recovering from damaging weather on Wednesday, some residents there are bracing for more. Charlene Israel reports.
Giant hail, flash flooding, and even tornadoes. All results of major storms from Colorado to the plains. Flooding closed down highways in both Ohio and Pennsylvania. But not before some motorists were trapped by the deep water.
I cannot even go home. I can't. So I was thinking about going back to work. There's no way out. Everywhere you look, the water is high.
I've got a book in the car. If I have to be here for a couple hours, I'll just be here. I've never seen it like this.
In the Denver area, golf ball-sized hail had cars sliding and people running for cover. At the Denver International Airport, some planes were damaged, and snow plows had to come out to clear the runways. At least six tornadoes were spotted, but there are no reports of any significant damage. Tonight, Denver is once again in the bullseye. New York City, Philadelphia, and Washington, D.C. are also in the path of storms that could turn severe. Authorities warn early holiday travelers to stay alert and check the forecast as they go into the weekend. Charlene Aaron, CBN News.
Coming up, could a food tax help curb obesity? Why some at the United Nations say it is needed.
Yeah. Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum, you and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute.
Superbook!
No!
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen. Plus, two copies to share with others. All for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah. Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him! He is alive!
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
The American Bible Challenge is back. Premiering tonight at 8, 7 Central. Jeff Foxworthy is ready to play.
The whole family's gonna love it.
Kirk Franklin's gonna sway.
Are you ready?
And you'll see the Bible in a whole new way.
Don't I look chic?
That was impressive.
An all-new season premieres tonight at 8, 7 Central. Only on Game Show Network.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
The American Bible Challenge is back. Premiering tonight at 8, 7 Central. Jeff Foxworthy is ready to play.
The whole family's gonna love it.
Kirk Franklin's gonna sway.
Are you ready?
And you'll see the Bible in a whole new way.
Don't I look chic?
That was impressive.
An all-new season premieres tonight at 8, 7 Central. Only on Game Show Network.
Welcome back. Should the world impose taxes on unhealthy food? The United Nations lead food expert says yes. Olivia De Chateur is the UN Special Rapporteur on the Right to Food. He says obesity has become more dangerous than tobacco, and the international community needs to do more to prevent it. De Chateur is calling UN members to tax unhealthy foods, limit access to foods high in saturated fats, salt, and sugar, as well as boost food distribution from local producers.
Dr. Linda Mental is a family therapist and an author of several books about weight loss and healthy body image, and they're wonderful. I especially loved your book called Press Pause Before Eating, and you have a few others, too, that I would highly recommend to our viewers.
I do. I wrote Lose It for Life, which was a bestseller about weight loss and raising healthy weight kids, and that's a really good one for getting your kids on the right track.
And also, you look at the world through a Christian worldview,
right.
So that's
right.
Bonus as well. So let's talk about what the UN is discussing about taxing unhealthy food. Mm-hmm. Do you think things like this, where we tax cigarettes or alcohol, prevents unhealthy behavior?
Well, let's look at what Denmark did, because Denmark tried this, and they actually put a tax on unsaturated or high saturated fat foods. And what they found was that it did not change consumer behavior at all in terms of buying it. There was one study in the Archives of Internal Medicine that did show that when they put a tax on pizza and soda, there was some decrease in people buying that food. So there's mixed results on whether this will actually work if people try it.
A lot of people are opposed to the government getting involved in our lives on this level, but then a lot of other people say, What's wrong with it?
Well, the overreach is definitely the concern. People are thinking, who is the government to pick the winners and the losers of food? And I think one of the more important issues, though, is that, is this going to become a burden to the poor? Because one of the things we know, Lori, is when we look at the studies, that when you're faced with five for a dollar, let's say macaroni and cheese, which is a highly processed food, which doesn't have a lot of nutrition, and a little pint of raspberries that's really good for you, the five for one macaroni and cheese is a whole lot cheaper. So a lot of this is an economic issue for people when they're looking at buying food.
Mm-hmm. And clearly something needs to be done. If not taxing right. these foods, then what?
Well, taxing them, again, I'm not saying that that isn't going to happen. One of the other suggestions is always, well, let's subsidize healthy foods. Mm-hmm. But when they did the study again and they put it out there, people did buy some of the healthier foods when they were subsidized. But here's what they did. They took the leftover money that they made and they used it to buy junk food.
Yeah.
So it didn't really work by itself. So the issue is, maybe this is one strategy, but then you've got to look at all the factors that go into obesity. So you've still got to deal with people getting much more active in movement. You've still got to look at portion control. You still have to look to the emotional side of eating, which is where
big.
I sort of live and breathe with people. And you have to get at the root of why we're doing this. And let's face it, food is good. It's a comfort. It's a friend. It's there when you need it. And it's one of those ways that we feel pleasure. And in a culture of overabundance, you know, when you've got it all around you, it's easy to indulge.
Right. And then you always hear the people say, well, I don't have time to cook healthy. You know, I have to do the fast food, the convenience food, because I'm so busy.
Well, I've got a lot in my book about that. I've pulled out the old crock pot again and started that going in the morning. You don't have to do anything. You throw a bunch of stuff in at the end of the day. But the truth is, when you're dealing with trying to lose weight, there are absolutely no shortcuts. So you do have to put the time and energy into preparing healthier food. If we could get people off of all this processed food mm-hmm. and get people more into farmers markets and community gardens and those things, it would help in terms of the type of food we're eating. But you got to take the time and you've got to be able to put the energy into it. That's the only way you get good results on most things.
You have to make it a priority.
Yeah,
thank you,
you
so much. Great information. Dr. Linda Menzel.
Up next, a cheaper and cleaner way to make gasoline that's being blocked by the government. We explain when we come back.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Some Democrats are fighting back against new Obama administration proposals on coal-fired power plants. In a new letter, seven Democratic senators call on the president to scale back. They say we're committed to improving air quality. However, the emission standards in the proposed rule are not based on technology that's been adequately demonstrated on a commercial scale. Some say these proposals are the latest in the administration's war on coal, a war the White House denies.
Coal is getting more expensive to mine, and these new rules are scaring potential investors away from groundbreaking projects. But as Caitlin Burke reports, some still believe the natural resource of the past could be key to America's future.
This is the vision for the Adams Fork coal-to-liquid plant in Mingo County, West Virginia. Developers believe it could literally change how the U.S. does business.
The refinery that we're going to build that will take coal and create gasoline will do it cheaper and cleaner than taking petroleum and making gasoline.
America is the world's number one importer of crude oil, holding that title for almost 50 years. Much of that oil becomes gasoline to keep our cars and trucks running. When the price of oil goes up, so does the price at the pump. But what if we had what it took to make gasoline right here in the U.S.? According to the BP Review of World Energy, we do, in the form of the world's largest coal reserves. The developers of the Adams Fork plant say converting coal into liquid fuel would pave the way towards energy independence. Their goal is to produce 250 million gallons of methanol that could be used as gasoline, jet fuel, diesel fuel, and more.
This wide open space that you see all around me is where that liquid coal plant should already be. But after years of fighting federal regulations, project coordinators say it won't be open until 2016. And because of the EPA, investors are still afraid.
Project coordinators say coal investments are labeled as risky. The Obama administration portrays it as a dirty energy source, while the EPA continues to pile on new regulations. The EPA justified its actions to CBN News with the following statement. EPA's ongoing challenge is to address pollution from coal and take steps to protect our nation's children and families from toxic air pollutants like mercury, arsenic, and nickel, pollutants that put Americans, especially children, at risk for developmental disorders and respiratory illnesses like asthma. Plant developer Adam Victor simply calls that message inaccurate.
The EPA and the environmentalists are creating a problem that doesn't exist. I just came back from Ulaanbaatar in Mongolia. I couldn't breathe. I couldn't breathe because of the burning of coal in Soviet-era style power plants. That's pollution. That is something that should be outlawed, banned, remediated, okay? We don't have that issue over here. And we basically have the highest standard of living in the world, and we still have beautiful and pristine skies.
The president of the West Virginia Coal Association, Bill Rainey, agrees. He says Washington doesn't recognize the industry's progress.
It's got a long history, and people rely on that history to refer to it as a dirty fossil fuel. And you do. You get your hands black when you touch it, and it's dusty. But we've learned how to control the dust, and you know, we're getting better every day.
When the Adams Fork plant is up and running, Victor says it will be strong proof of clean coal technology by almost zero emissions. Mingo County welcomes this opportunity. It's prepared for a liquid coal plant for years, and as Victor searched for a place to build, Mingo County came up with the land and infrastructure needed for the project.
Picking southern West Virginia, Mingo County in particular, has been such a godsend for us because the last 20 years we've prepared for this moment, not knowing what this moment was going to be, but we prepared for this moment in our minds and in our dreams and our visions.
State and local leaders say the liquid coal plant will help revive the local economy, bringing thousands of jobs to the area. And locals agree. They're hoping that families will stay put instead of moving out of state to find work.
Some of our best and brightest leave here because we just don't have the opportunities for them in their chosen profession or occupation or vocation. They go elsewhere, and we're trying to create that market here so our kids don't have to leave.
The Adams Fork plant will bring more than 3,000 jobs during construction over the next 4 to 5 years. 300 people will work full-time here when it's complete. Victor hopes Adams Fork and two proposed plants in Kentucky could eventually lead to a national synthetic fuels program. Realistically, however, he says that's an impossible dream as long as the EPA continues to exist in its current form.
When people oppose the coal industry, they should really think long and hard and take a history lesson on how important that coal and that steel has been to American civilization and American freedom and the freedom of all Western democracies. The Panama Canal was built by steel that was made from coal that came from West Virginia. Imagine the world without the Panama Canal. And by the way, if you had an EPA, do you think you could have permitted the Panama Canal?
Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
Up next, see how elementary school students are standing up to bullying.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids, do you love games? And do you love discovering things? Yeah. Well, do you? Yeah.
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes and Google Play now.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Students at an elementary school in Wisconsin are taking a personal approach to combat bullying at their school.
They've created a friend bench. Third graders at St. Joseph's Catholic School were sad that some kids did not have friends to play with at recess time, so they started thinking of ways to change that and came across the idea of a friend bench online.
We go over by them and say, hey, what's wrong? And then we say, do you want to be friends with us?
A first grader, and she has four other boys in her class and no girls, so they don't really play with her that much. So I've seen her on the friend bench a few times, and I've come over to talk to her.
Say, thanks for being my friend. Yeah, I like you.
Oh, that's great. What great kids. Maturity level's amazing. The friend bench was first started by a first grader, believe it or not, in Pennsylvania. Boy, all schools need a friend bench, don't you think?
Absolutely.
Don't that you feel you... bad for that kid that's out there all alone? I know.
Oh, so sad. That gives you hope for the future.
That's right. Well, that's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again here tomorrow.